Now, it was one of the most dominant eras in college basketball history, more than 600 victories in stores, 7 Big East tournament titles, and 3 national championships. In his book, Shock the World, UConn Basketball in the Calhoun Era, Peter Burns Jr. looks into the 25 years Coach Calhoun spent at UConn and how he changed not just a team, but a state, a university, and really the college basketball scene. I think you could say for really New England, the culture here has changed quite a bit. Peter Burns joins us now to talk about the book, and welcome. Thank you for being here.
Thank you, Jeff.
I understand you came up from New Orleans.
I did. Okay. I came up yesterday from New Orleans. No problems.
Okay. Well, good of you to come up here. And you, by the way, so you're a UConn alum, but you're very familiar also with New Haven.
Yes. Yes. My family, my mother's side of the family, the O'Keefes, lived in Morris Cove for a long time, so we have roots here.
Oh, okay. And you teach poli sci down at Loyola.
Yes. I teach political science. I am a professor of urban politics, American government, all the American politics type classes, state and local politics.
So naturally, you wrote a book about sports.
Yes. Well,
how did you come up with the idea?
Well, after Hurricane Katrina, I was living with the Jesuit priests at Fairfield University, mm-hmm. and I said, I need to take my mind off of this. And so I need something to write about. And so I decided to write about UConn basketball. It was something I knew and something I liked. And so I wrote about that, and 7 years later, the book came out.
How about that? And by the way, I should point out, it says here in 2002, UConn's Alumni Association named you Outstanding Young Alumnus of the Year.
Yes, that's because I was on the committee the year before and I knew the rules, but I'm not going to say that to anybody out there.
Shh, don't tell anyone. This is how we keep secrets. We just keep it among our viewers.
Yes.
All right. Anyway, you never had a one-on-one interview with Mr. Calhoun.
Right.
Right? Why is that, and what did you learn about him nevertheless by writing the book?
Well, I interviewed him at his reunion games, but as you said, it wasn't a one-on-one interview. I don't know why I wasn't granted a one-on-one interview. You'd have to ask the coach about that. What did I learn? Calhoun said after the 2011 national championship, if you want to know about me, ask my players. So I asked his players.
All right.
And I learned about a guy who was very tough on them, who they didn't really like all that much when they played for him, but they love now and consider him to be like a father to them.
A father figure. So when you're talking, and I would think that would be kind of an interesting thing when you're, I mean, obviously if you're writing about somebody historically, somebody who's long since passed on, that's one thing. You're really reading accounts, but here you are talking about a person who's very much alive and with us and very vital, and yet you're talking with people around them.
Yes.
And so that must be an interesting experience in writing the book like this. And so what else did you learn? What surprised you perhaps about Jim Calhoun?
He's a very private person.
Mm-hmm.
He's in a very public job. He's very different, I think, off the court than he is on the court. He's not always high strung and vocal, but on the court he is. And so I think there are different Jim Calhouns, but he's very much a family person, likes his family. So those kinds of things struck me, Jeff.
And what was it that made him a good fit for UConn? Because I mean, every coach, and certainly you have, unlike in the NBA, or maybe somewhat like the NBA, you've got a constant rotation of players coming through. And so how does one guy make it work for so long?
A matter of will. Mm-hmm. That's a very difficult thing to define, a matter of will. But Jim Calhoun just would not lose. He would not lose. He would not accept anything but excellence and perfection from the university. I mean, the university didn't know how to run a college basketball program. They did things on the cheap. Calhoun said, if we're going to be a first-rate operation, we're going to have to do things first-rate. We're going to have the best uniform, stay at the best hotels, have the best facilities. And he brought UConn with them, kicking and screaming to a certain extent, but he wouldn't lose. He would just never give up. I wrote in the book, he's like Tom Petty's, I won't back down. He will not back down, he didn't in a 26-year career.
Something sure worked there, indeed. And we know you have some book signings coming up.
Yes.
We have to finish up, but we will give you the information for those book signings. Well, real quick, where are those?
Well, today I'm going to be at 10 o'clock at the Barnes & Noble in Enfield, 1 o'clock in West Hartford at the Barnes & Noble, and then next Saturday at 2 o'clock at the Milford Barnes & Noble.
Perfect. Peter Burns, Jr., thank you very much.